In this video, we'll see how to draw an empirical graph by hand. To start, we need to be given information about the population mean and standard deviation. We will suppose the population mean is given, it's 23, and the standard deviation is given as 5. We now draw the bell curve. Start with a nice horizontal line. And draw the nice bell curve shape over top. Now draw a nice vertical line right down the middle. Label the horizontal axis here with the value of the mean. We're now going to divide each half into 4 pieces by drawing 3 vertical lines. Space the vertical lines equally on the horizontal scale. The distance between these horizontally is the standard deviation. So we can label these new points by adding the standard deviation to the mean. 23 plus 5 is 28. 28 plus 5 is 33. 33 plus 5 is 38. Now we do the same thing on the other side. This time we subtract the mean, the standard deviation from the mean. 23 minus 5 is 18. 18 minus 5 is 13. 13 minus 5 is 8. Now we just need to label the areas in the middle, for that the total area can be thought of as 100%. And we will just talk about the percentages of each of these areas. Now, according to the empirical rule, the distance, or the area one standard deviation above and below, is 68% of the total area. That means that each of these pieces, because of symmetry, are 34%. According to the empirical rule, 95% of the population is within 2 standard deviations. And they've already accounted for 68%, so subtracting 68% from 95% leaves us with 27%. And we split that into 2, and we get 13.5%. According to the empirical rule, going out 3 standard deviations would give us 99.7% of the population. Since 95% is already accounted for, that just leaves 4.7%. Splitting that in 2, we get 2.35% and 2.35%. So clearly the last 0.3% is in the small tails on the left and right. Splitting that in half, you can see that each one is 0.15%. And you can now use the values on the horizontal axis along with these percentages to determine what proportion of individuals lie in a number of different intervals. We should finish by titling the graph and labeling the horizontal axis. In most situations, this number has some application or relevance. We must interpret it. Suppose we were looking at the data set of temperatures. We just identify the horizontal axis as being temperature. And we're ready to go.